Hello everyone, welcome back to Crawl Out Through the Fallout. I'm your host, Themis.
I'm that traitor.
Last episode, basically...
Aaron's cat managed to get out of the vault. Can't imagine he'll live too long out there in the Commonwealth.
I hope he'll live. That's what I'm trying to do, is get out there and find him. Yeah, so yeah, last episode, explored Vault 81. Got a few quests, told some kids about how terrifying life outside the vault is. All about killing Deathclaws with the help of Preston. He was actually no help at all. It was entirely me. He was just in his little bunker the entire time while I was doing the heavy lifting. But yeah, now there's a little cat that got out, and I'm going to find that cat, bring it back. Here, Kitty Kitty's the name of the quest. Hope the cat, you know, isn't too dead. So there's a quest marker that's really close. Only 90 meters. Okay, get my handy-dandy shiv out. Quick save, jump. Don't quite make it onto the roof. 70. Oh. Is it over there? Maybe it's across the other side of the little lake here. Is that the kit? Is that the cat? No, it's not a cat. That's a blue thing. It's not a cat. It's a crate. And what is this? Coffee tin. Oh, I'm actually... What a place to be getting your caffeine fix. There's ghouls in there last I was here. I didn't appreciate them. None. Oh, there's a super mutant around there as well. There was. Kitty. Hey, kitty. Hey.
Ashes, go home. Aaron misses you.
Ashes, go home! Aaron misses you! Oh, man. What an obedient... That's not a real cat. Can you imagine? A cat being like, yeah, I'm actually gonna do what you say. Because I actually, you know, listen to what you have to say about me and care. It's no dog, it's a cat we're talking about. And I know some cat... Oh, that's some really weird puddles. They're, like, vertical. Like, I've known some cats who've been some real dicks. But it's just so cute. Okay, and once again, I have returned to the vault in order to let Aaron know that her little kitty kitty, little kitty kitty, is all safe and sound. You kitty. Where'd you go? There you are. There you are, little kitty. Well, look how cute you are when you run. Yeah, you just wanted to see a little bit of the outside.
Stay safe, sir.
I will.
Watch out for the maintenance. It never ends around here.
Did that cat just phase through the elevator? Man, that is intense, man. So intense. So yeah, I'm not sure if you've been checking out my other series that I've had so far. I have really been enjoying playing through. I think I have a few up now. I have Never Alone and A Story About My Uncle. They're tons of fun. I have thoroughly enjoyed A Story About My Uncle. It has just been...
Austin got himself bit by a mole rat. So now they got us cooped up in here to watch Aaron. It's ridiculous.
Wait, what?
Ashes! You found him! Thanks, mister! I was so worried about him.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
I'm so glad he's safe.
Ashes! Oh, Fusion Core. Hey!
If you need something, ask Alexis. I can't make heads or tails of this sort. Give you a bath.
Looking for something? I have more stuff than I know what to do with.
Am I supposed to talk to you about...
But I'm just happy you're back.
I'll think about it.
Browse all you want. No rush.
Well, I completed here Kitty Kitty. Where's that little shit, Austin? Nah, I don't care about Austin. He's a little shit. I'm gonna go upstairs. Oh, dog, we didn't make it in time. Oh, I can command him. Oh, he's right here. Hey, dog meat. You also phase through elevators. What quest am I now working on? I'm working on... Getting a clue, yeah, that's right. I'm going heading back to Diamond City. And away we go. So yeah, I am trying to try and get maybe two videos a day out. I think Fallout, I want to have Fallout every day if I can help it. Just a Fallout video a day, you know, keeps the subscribers happy, maybe? I don't know. But that's my hope for now, is do a Fallout video a day and then do maybe some other kind of video. Like I mentioned, I'm playing Never Alone, and I'm playing a story about my uncle. Oh, that's a great game. Never Alone is very charming. It's a nice atmosphere, a really cool storyteller, and just Native Legends have always been something that I've really enjoyed. Like, just how other people, like, either their creation stories or how they see the world. Where am I headed to right now, by the way? I want to be on the world map, I think. That's Diamond City there. Oh, I hear some popping. I don't hear any locking or dropping, though. Where? I don't know where you are, boy. Dog meat. Dog meat. What do you find? Oh. Oh, dog meat. You are my hero. There goes my hero. Watch him as he sniffs. Because his name is Dog Meat. What's in here? Can I just... Come on, let me jump. But yeah, I'm going to try and do a Fallout video every day, and then some other kind of Let's Play video, just to kind of fill in the gap. I'm really enjoying this, Never Alone. It's just, like I mentioned, it's a very charming, like, just nice and peaceful story. It's just, it puts me in a real nice mood whenever I'm playing. And then there's also a story about my uncle, which is also just, it's gorgeous. It's a physics-based platformer, and it's just cool. Like, it's just flying around and being able to, like, grapple, and I'm really enjoying that game. I'm really glad that I did decide to get it in, like, a Humble Bundle sale. And then there's also, there's Europa Universalis, but I don't know if too many people are too interested in that. It's a game, like, I've got way too many hours in that game, and it's a game that I've always really enjoyed, but I think I'm going to try and cut down on that. I used to have, I think, a video of that a day as well, but I think I might just cut down to maybe a video a week or two videos a week. Yeah, I guess just kind of try and stagger it out. But Fallout, I think right now, is going to be my main series. But let me know if there's anything else that you'd want to see. If there are any other series that you
no way I'm
enjoy. I can't get in here. What was the point? So just grab your pre-war money. Ding ding. Yeah, because I am definitely looking for. I mean, this will probably be another 100 parts. Let's be honest. I mean, I'm gonna keep playing this game until people tell me they're sick of it, and even then, I'll probably play it for a little bit longer. But I really do enjoy Fallout, and there's so much to see and there's so much to do that this game. It's almost like a vlog type. Let's catch up on Themis's life while he plays with a little bit of Fallout in the background. And I like it. I hope you like it. And if you don't like it, well, it's unfortunate, and I'll have to find something else to fill the void in the meantime. But yeah, I mean, not that far in the story. I mean, I've been playing for, what, it's like 12, 13 hours now, and I've just barely unlocked Vault 81. I've released Valentine. I mean, there's not that much to do, not that much to have done in this short amount of time. Like, I've seen people, like, on the day Fallout came out, had already pretty much rushed the entire storyline. But I mean, that's not kind of the way. Oh, Okay, I can help. I can help. My time to shine. My time to shine. Oh, that hurt. That hurt. Oh. So that raider met a sticky end. Dogmeat, you go to it, boy. I'm very gristly. I'm not very tasty. I'm very stringy, I'd say. Yep. Just don't mind me. I'm helping out Diamond City Security. He had a bit of a tumble there. If he wasn't dead, he was definitely dead when he hit the ground. I think I explored this before. I don't think there was too much to see, though. Yeah, there wasn't too much to see up here. Yeah, I did. I definitely explored here before. Okay, how do I get back over to you, Dogmeat? Just... Oh! Oh, broke my kneecaps. Oh, they're entirely broken. It's painful to walk. It's painful to walk. Is there anything in here? There's some mentats? Mentats, is that how you say it? Oh, and something else. I mean, this is something my mom is really going to be proud of. Over the holidays, she got me a slow cooker. And today is the first day I've actually gotten around to using it. I'm trying to make, it's like a stew type deal. It's like just nice fresh cut up carrots, fresh celery, onions, some canned baked beans. What else? Oh, some cut up fresh tomatoes and some canned tomatoes and some garlic and some, a little bit of additional flavorings. And it should be very good. I'm hoping it'll be a good, like, good with rice. Maybe a good pasta topping, a good pasta sauce. Armor-piercing automatic pipe rifle. Nah, it's not something that I'm too excited about. Right on, right. You have right foot bones on you, bud. Yeah. She's been hounding me for a while about about using it. Have I been using it enough? Finally, I can let her know. Yes, I have used it, and yes, it is looking like, ooh, water glue. Looking like it's going to be delicious. It smells good, and it looks fairly good too. So, I'm excited for that. Yeah, and we're back at Diamond City. I think we just need to find Nick Valentine now, right? This way. Oh, you're evil. No, I don't want a content ID. Oh, man. Hey there. And in we go. You know what? I think, actually, because I have the Rad X, I can try doing that little boys quest where I clear out the water. Huh. So you can actually, if I start hearing that clicking, I can still quickly stop the ticking instead of blowing my legs off like I have been. Oh, hey kitty. Hello. Hi. Oh, look at your little paws. Look at your little paws. So cute. So cute. Man, I love animals, but I'm just allergic. That still is, wow, it's still there. I'm just allergic to everything. Like, I'm allergic to dogs, I'm allergic to cats, I'm allergic to horses. Don't ask me how I know. I'll tell you how I know I'm allergic to horses is when I was a kid, I used to work at a summer camp, and part of that summer camp duties was, like, the equestrian management, the equestrian stuff. So I took care of horses, fed horses, rode horses, cleared horses. And just... I also broke out in hives. I mean, I didn't know it was related, but apparently it was. So, that's how I learned. But I have... Okay, so I'm only taking a few rats. Oh, there's a toaster. Take the upper skull. Why is there a skull in here? I don't know. But yeah, I always enjoyed... I enjoyed riding horses, and I enjoyed taking care of them. And... it's just... it's unfortunate. Like, I think it's... like, I'd never realized how much I was suffering until... like, I was no longer in that environment. Like, the same thing with, like, with my dog. Like, I've had... oh, she's a gorgeous coonhound that I think I've mentioned before. Oh, I didn't want to drink that water. I did not want to drink that water. I wanted to grab the tire. But yeah, like, I love my dog to death, but I didn't realize how allergic I was and how miserable I was until I went... like, I left home for about a year, and then came home in the summer, for the Christmas break, and just how itchy and sneezy and sore and hivesy I got. Like, I just didn't realize. And just, I mean, like, it's like something as well, like, with dairy, too. It's funny how I find things out is by, quitting cold turkey and then coming back to it later. But, with, like, dairy, for the summer, I thought... wondering if I'm gonna be there when I wake up.
What are you, nuts? You wouldn't last an hour out there. I'll take my chances on this side of the Green Guardian. Thanks.
I never talked to these guys before.
Don't know you, Scabba.
What's this? Marinas. But yeah, with dairy, I decided, hey, you know what I'm gonna try and do this summer? I worked same summer camp that I'd worked at before. They had vegetarian and vegan options as well, and I thought, you know, I can like this vegetarian option. Probably not even. Oh, I don't want to use the Radex. I don't think. Does it stack? If I use another Radex, but I want to use the Radaway. Open for business. Oh no, it doesn't stack. Okay. But yeah, what's the point of my story again? Yeah, milk. So they had this vegetarian and vegan option, and there was another guy who was, he was already a vegan, and I'm like, it's not this tough, not that tough at all, I bet I could do this, and I'd be fine. And, well, turns out I was, either the whole time I was lactose intolerant, or I definitely, over the course of summer, learned, or made myself lactose intolerant, because by the end of that summer, I was...
I ain't standing here for my health. Look how clean the water is now. Good job. Here's your pay. Now, how about you pick up some bottles for the road?
Shang, why was there a skull in the water?
So maybe you weren't the first person I asked. Even the last guy found an unstable hand grenade. Hey, once the filters do their job, it's all water under the bridge. Am I right?
Gosh, anyway, you're a crazy little bald kid. Water?
You by yourself out here?
That's right. Been on my own since I was 8. I'm a fully independent man. Got my own place. Go to night classes. The whole shebang. Now, how about I get you a bottle of water, huh?
Man. Not interested.
Now. You're lost, jackass.
You little prick. What was that one? I like how as soon as I put it away, everyone's just like, oh, okay, it's cool. It's cool. You know how to stab the shit out of that little kid, but hey, it's cool. Hey, how's it going? Yep. That little dick had it coming, though. Call me a jackass because I don't want any of his overpriced water and he tried to kill me in the drowny lake thing. But yeah, oh yeah, the milk. I was like, yeah, this isn't that bad.
A shotgun's great for its intimidation factor.
I was like, yeah, I can do that. That's easy. No problem. Needless to say, I... like, like, towards the middle of summer, like, after I'd been off dairy for a while, and just when I had, like, an ice cream or something, I was just like, I suddenly feel really, really sick. Or whenever I had cheese, I was like, man, like, I don't feel well. Like, I didn't...
Here?
Nick?
Oh.
Oh, God. It's really you.
It
well,
is.
It's hard to mistake this mug for anyone else.
You keep laughing at death. Someday, death's gonna laugh back.
Not as long as I got a few friends to back me
you
up.
Got that
you
right.
Said Nick, this agency, and my job. Thank you.
Ooh.
Can we get started on my case?
Oh, of course. There's just a small clerical thing we need to clear up. Here. I know an amount wasn't on the table when you went out to find him, but you deserve a reward. Plus a little something extra. You know, if you're looking for work and don't mind putting on the detective hat, Nick sure could use a new partner.
Whoa. One case at a time, Ellie.
Oh,
our new friend needs our help first. All right, let's get down to business.
Wait.
See.
Wait. Faded trench coat and what was the other thing? Worn fedora?
Make yourself comfortable.
Look at this. Look at this. I'm Nick. I'm Nick Valentine. Hey, buddy. Look at that. We're twinsies, except you're a creepy synth and I'm cool. But I want my... Grognak. And I want my... leather for now. Get that pocketed, shadowed, good stuff. And then I want a military cap, because I get the perception. Yeah. So if I look at... where do I look? I don't see... oh!
The Marty Bullfinch case. Marty was Nick's partner. Emphasis on the was. He must have been some kind of desperate to come to us for help after all this time.
Well, Marty and I never exactly saw eye to eye. Mostly because he was usually passed out on the barroom floor.
Aw, come on, Nick. Think of the good times.
What, when I quit?
Yeah, that's the one I'm thinking of.
Yeah, I felt sick, and then it wasn't until later I realized, oh, it's
trying to find
Gary.
Someone who's gone missing. The devil is in the details. Tell me everything you can, no matter how painful it might be.
Okay. I'm going to describe... Sean.
I'm looking for my son, Sean. He's less than a year old. Why would anyone take him?
Good question. Why your family in particular?
I know, and why an infant?
Why an infant? Someone would be taking on all of his care, and a baby needs a lot of it. What else can you tell me?
There was a man and a woman. They didn't say much. But I remember they called me...
That looks so sick.
...backup.
So we're talking a small team. Professionals. The kind that know to keep their lips tight when they're on the job. Not sure what the backup means, though. Well, that confirms it. This isn't a random kidnapping. Whoever took your kid had an agenda. There's a lot of groups in the Commonwealth that take people. Raiders. Super mutants. The Gunners. And, of course, there's the Institute.
Oh, I don't believe in the Institute. Bullcrap that Piper keeps spawning. Ugh. Let's talk about the Gunners.
Who are the Gunners?
High-end mercenaries. No job too brutal. They're in the running as likely suspects. They wouldn't be the ones pulling the strings.
What about the Institute?
So you think this Institute is responsible?
Well, they're the boogeymen of the Commonwealth. Something goes wrong, everyone blames them. Easy to see why. Those early model synths of theirs strip whole towns for parts, killing everything in their way.
Yeah, what about you?
Newer models, good as human, that infiltrate cities and pull strings from the shadows. Worst of all, no one knows why they do it, what their plan is, or where they are. Not even me. And I'm a synth myself. A discarded prototype, anyway.
You're a prototype?
You're a prototype?
As far as I know, never seen any other synth like myself. There's the older ones that are dumb as rocks and all metal, and there's the newer ones that are almost human. I'm somewhere in between.
You don't know anything about them? Really?
Some kind of security setting strips or blocks out those memories. And it's not just me. Any synth that gets trashed, left behind, or escapes the Institute has the same problem. Probably some kind of failsafe.
Either way, I need to find Sean.
You're right. The speculation...
Yeah, I'm gonna find that kid.
Track. Let's focus on what you saw. What did these kidnappers look like?
Distinctive voice.
I'll never forget that voice. Low and rough. Like sandpaper across your face.
Not much to go on, but a tough and commanding voice can get someone pretty far.
I guess that's true. Business.
What else?
Carried a gun.
Man who killed my wife. He had a handgun. I didn't get a clear look at it, but that sound...
Could have been a large caliber revolver. I'm starting to get a clearer picture of the kind of man...
Gun-toting bastard.
Is. Anything more you can tell me?
Describe their outfits.
The woman was dressed in, I think it was a kind of hazard suit. The man had some sort of metal brace on his arm.
Maybe some kind of improvised armor? A lot of hired guns do that to look tough. The hazard suit is interesting. Not many mercs can afford something that fancy. What else do you remember about them?
Bald and scarred.
One of them came right up to me. Bald head. Scar across his left eye.
Wait. It couldn't be. You didn't hear the name Kellogg at all, did you?
Oh, yeah. I heard their names, their home addresses, and where their diary keys are hidden.
All right, calm down. Way too big of a coincidence. Ellie, what notes do we have about the Kellogg case?
The description matches. Bald head, scar, reputation for dangerous mercenary work, but no one knows who his employer is.
And he bought a house here
in town,
right?
Why do you have a case on him?
And he had a kid with him, didn't he?
Yeah, that's right. The house in the abandoned West Stands. The boy with him was around 10 years old.
10 years old. I mean, another kidnapped kid.
Maybe it's another kidnapped kid.
Yeah, either that or he's got a son of his own. Comforting thought in any case.
I mean, it could be Sean. I mean, I was frozen again.
Haven't been heard or seen since. Let's you and I take a walk over to Kellogg's last known address. See if we can snoop out where he went.
Security doesn't really go to that part of town, but you two should still be careful.
I always am.
Oh, Valentine, you are such a badass. But, you know, I think that's enough for now. Next episode, we're going to follow Nick Valentine, find Kellogg's place, move a little bit closer to finding Sean. If you enjoyed this episode, please leave a comment down below letting me know what you thought, what I can improve on, what I can, or did well, what I can do better at. I would love to know. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. It really helps me out, helps me know that I'm doing the right thing, and kind of gives me a little bit more incentive to continue doing these videos in the future. And leave a like. That's also if you like the episode. Otherwise, anyway, for now, I'm Themis. Stay safe, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.